He goes, will I ever see you again? I said, I hope not. Over the years, we've had some pretty interesting and entertaining cases. And one of my favorites that I like to tell is, in California, a red light camera ticket is a point violation, which opposed to many states is just a money grab. So in California, not only do they take a picture of your license plate, but they take a picture of the driver through the window. We represented this one individual who happened to be on his way to work. His job was an entertainer as a drag queen. So he was at the time in full Marilyn Monroe regalia. Absolutely gorgeous woman. We go to court and he comes to court in a beautiful navy suit and tie, beard and a mustache. We go up, we go, judge, we're here on such and such a case. And the judge pulls up, takes a look at the picture, looks at him, looks at the picture again. He goes, oh, there must be some mistake. Case dismissed. So that was really pretty entertaining. Another case we had, as I told you, California will take a picture of the front window and the driver. And apparently they took a picture of a gentleman whose mistress was, shall we say, servicing him at the time. Now, because there's no officer involved, nobody pulls you over, they mail the ticket to you, right? So this particular gentleman, his wife checks the mail. She opened it up and she was like, what is this? It resulted in a lawsuit. Now California, in fact, blacks out one side of the photograph, and we were able on that basis as well to get the case dismissed. I don't go to court myself that much. I have quite a number of lawyers working for me. We've got 40 offices, but every once in a while when we have a problem, it's time to call Mark Gold. So we had a judge in a particularly redneck part of Florida. I'm not going to mention the county, but he was hammering our lawyers every time. I said, you know what? I'm going to have to go and deal with this judge. So we waited till we had 31 cases on the docket in one day, which for this little county was a lot. I went up, I brought a court reporter, and before the case started, the courtroom was full. It wasn't just our cases. It was a full courtroom. And I went up before the case. I said, morning, judge. My name's Mark Gold. I'm here on behalf of the ticket clinic and our 31 clients. He says, ah, yes, Mr. Gould. I'm like, oh, boy. Okay. He goes, what do you want? I said, well, rather than waste the court's time, if we can get a $75 fine, withhold, no points, no school, no record, I can resolve all these cases. I don't make no deals, Mr. Gould. I'm like, okay, call your first witness. It was a speeder, it was highway patrol, and I spent an hour and a half on that case. I felt kind of bad. She was a nice little trooper girl, and I made her cry. But I went through her high school education, the cosine factors of radar and the angles and her paperwork and everything. An hour and a half, I probably had 15 motions to dismiss, which he reserved on every one. And he said, I'm going to reserve on the case. I'm not going to make a ruling right now. Call your next case. So we did another one, different trooper, similar result, an hour. And at one point he goes, can you move it along, Mr. Gold? I said, judge, are you suggesting that my client isn't entitled to his full day in court, that I have to rush my cross-examination of the accusing witness? Now, don't put words in my mouth, Mr. Gould. And I said, Miss Court Reporter, did you get all that? She goes, yeah, I got it. I said, okay, proceed. So same thing, about an hour, hour and a half trial. A lot of problems with the case. Reserves ruling. Now it's about 11 o'clock. We call our third one. Same thing. I'm going through training, experience, radar training in particular. It's kind of interesting, actually. A part of their radar training, they sit with a radar gun with the training officer, and they have to guess the speed. But when they guess it, the training officer will tell them the actual speed and how far off they were. So they know the next time, oh, I was 3 miles an hour short, I better guess a little higher. Training's nonsense. But anyway, so and I took him through all that. And again, the judge reserved rulings. Now it's lunchtime. And he goes, well, everybody, we're going to take a break for lunch. This here lawyer is taking up all your time. And again, I said, judge, are you suggesting that I should rush my defenses and not present all the defenses entitled by law. Now, I didn't say that, Mr. Gould, Bob, et cetera, et cetera. Anyway, again, I turned to the court reporter. Did you get that, Ms. Court Reporter? She goes, I got it, Mr. Gould. He goes, okay, I want everybody out of here. Everybody go to lunch. So I get up. He goes, not you. He calls me up to the bench and he goes, what do you want? I said, I told you. $75 fine, no points, no school, no record. And he's like, how about 100? I said, okay, but you have to find not guilty the three that you made me go to trial on. He goes, will I ever see you again? I said, I hope not. And since then, that's the deal in that particular county. I can send any one of my guys up there and that's the deal, unless we have something really legitimate, you know, in which case the case will get thrown out. But we do very well there now. There are different speed measuring devices. There's Pace Clock, which is a calibrated speedometer, and there's all kinds of documents they need. We've won a lot of those because it has to be calibrated by a company that is DOT approved to do that. And they never bring that documentation. They'll bring the speedometer calibration and it'll say calibrated by such and so company approved by the department. Well, where's the department approval? So then there's radar, which we've talked about how we win those. And then there's laser, which if you don't know, laser is basically a light gun that they point and it measures the time it takes to bounce back to them. There's all kinds of requirements about how you have to calibrate a laser before you use it. And one of the requirements is that at the beginning of the shift, before they ever use it, they have to measure it against a measured 100-foot distance on a 12-by-12 metal sign. So we had a number of tickets with this one particular deputy. This wasn't a trooper, it was a deputy of county. And she was about to put the laser, the speed evidence in. Of course, I object and say, foundation. I go, let's talk about the calibration. She goes, oh, I calibrate it. Every morning I get up and I stand on a line I drew in my driveway, which is 100 feet away, and I shoot it at my mailbox and it says it's 100 feet. I'm like, excuse me, your what? It's my mailbox. So describe your mailbox. Well, it's a metal mailbox. And how big is it? She goes, oh, it's like 9 by 18, maybe. I said, so it's not 12 by 12. Oh, no. Okay, so it is not, let's just be clear, it's not a 12 by 12 metal sign. No, it is not. Okay, Your Honor, the rule's very clear. Okay, right here, it's got to be calibrated 100 feet on a 12 by 12 metal sign. Now, we haven't even talked about how she measured the 100 feet, but I don't think we need to go there because it's not properly calibrated. Judge is like, case dismissed. And then he said, anybody else here have a laser ticket with this particular young lady deputy? And half a dozen people stood up. He said, give your tickets to the clerk, you're all dismissed. One of the craziest tickets I've gotten, I wish I could find it. I had it framed and hanging in my office in Miami for years. I had a young lady pulled over for careless driving. When you get a careless driving ticket, as I told you before, they have to write to wit. They have to give you the reason you were carelessly driving. And I've never seen this before. It said, to wit, cat on shoulder. Cat on shoulder. Not cut someone off, not ran someone off the road, texting while driving, whatever. Cat on shoulder. Needless to say, we went to court. That is not a proper to wit clause. Case got dismissed. And actually, the judge got a nice little chuckle out of it as well. It was one of his more entertaining parts of his day. That was a real memorable one. I won't forget that one at all.
Finding your next dream car can be like searching for a needle in a haystack, but the best tool to use is AutoTempest.com. AutoTempest is the smartest and most powerful tool to search for your next car or your dream car because they allow you to search all the major listing sites at once. Their motto is all the cars, one search, and they've been supporting VinWiki for the last 3 years. Quite honestly, it's the first place I go to look when I'm searching for my next car, and I think that you'll absolutely love it. So check them out today at the link in the description below, and thank them for their continued support of VinWiki.